Hey there, welcome back. It's Cindy again. We are in Module 6 of Microsoft Word 2016, and we're talking about tables in this particular module. Now, this is section 2 where I want to show you actually how to create a table because there's a couple of different ways to do it. So, let me show you how to get started creating a table. There are four different ways to insert a table. The first way is if you click on the Insert tab, you're going to see the table option, and then you're going to see a grid right here that indicates how many columns and rows you'll be inserting into your table. Notice if you drag across 5 and down 3, that means you're going to have 5 columns across and 3 rows down. You're just going to click, and then there's your table. A few things I want you to notice about the table. You'll notice that you have borders around each cell. These will print. You can actually remove them, you can actually edit them, format them any way you want, so we'll be working with borders a little bit later. Also notice that you now have a Table Tools Contextual tab. Under the Table Tools Contextual tab, you have a Design tab, which is going to allow you to change some of the design elements about your table, and then the Layout tab, which has a lot of options as far as if you want to insert rows or columns, things like that. And we'll be looking at a lot of these different options. Some other things to notice. There is actually a little box on the top left of your table. By clicking on that box, that is a way to select the table. That way, if you wanted to do something that affects the entire table, then you could now do it since the whole thing is selected. Also, these are floating tables. If you had some data in this particular document already, you can grab this little box and drag it around and your text will actually wrap around the table. Something else to notice is this. When you insert a table like we did into a blank document, there's not even one blank row above the table if you wanted to put some text there. I wanted to show you how to fix that real quick. If you're in the first cell and you're in front of the first character of text, then all you have to do is hit the Enter key and it will throw you up above your table so you can put some text out in your document. That's not going to work anywhere else, okay? So just know you have to be in front of the first character of text in the first cell and then you hit the Enter key. I want to go ahead and type some data in here. Typically, your top row is what they call your header row. Headers just indicate what type of data happens to be below in those columns. So I'm going to put in the date order, the item name, we'll say the stock number, we'll say quantity ordered, and the last one we're going to say amount each. Notice I'm just hitting the Tab key to move back and forth between the cells. Shift Tab is going to go to the left and Tab is going to go to the right. Let me go ahead and plug in some dates here. We'll say this one is the 12th. We'll say Blue Buffalo Tags. Stock number, we'll say 2152, 15 ordered, and these are $1.52 each. One more line here. We'll say this one is May the 1st of 2016. This is Pacific Purple Paint. Did you notice in this particular case that the column wasn't wide enough, so the paint went on to the next line? We're going to talk a little bit about fixing things like that shortly. This number is going to be 8328. There's two of these. And they're $17.98 each. You have the ability in a table to actually change the width of your columns and your rows that it automatically inserts. You might have noticed all of the columns are the exact same width. That's why this one word wrapped. All I have to do to change the column width is place your mouse on the line that separates the columns, and then you can start dragging left or right to change some of the widths. So if this one here wanted to be a little bit smaller, I can do this. I can do something like this. And then that way, item name happens to be a larger column. I want to talk to you a little bit now about how to add rows and columns to your table. So let's go ahead and go over to section 3 and I will show you how to add columns and rows.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you need additional Microsoft Office 2016 training, check out our multi-hour training courses for Office 2016. Click the Learn More button on the left and I'll see you next week with additional videos.